time.
I was looking.
The Canadian Open from York University, the National Tennis Center of Canada. Berger and Michael Chang dead even, one set apiece in this championship match.
Final set, Berger and
Kim Prince is at courtside today. Their records in deciding sets.
You know, that little turn of events of the close call and those things could be devastating to most players, and it may end up being devastating to Jay Berger, but I think he at least has the mental toughness to get over it. But it can turn a match around.
Been around long enough now. He's 23, about to be 24 years old. He's a real pro. Mm-hmm.
Sure is.
He's a very good press conference. He's outgoing, lively.
Kim, did you just notice, did Chang start to grab his leg just then?
Well, he did, but I can't tell you whether he's cramping or not. I really can't. I thought perhaps he was, but don't think so.
No. Oh! 46.
I thought Jay Berger was mine, and the press conference today was a beauty of that. He didn't expect to see a duck in the final here, right? He really, he has a very wry, understated sense of humor.
Game point, Berger, first game of the third set.
It's a page out of Agassi's book here, but he goes in for, takes a volley out of the, very near the baseline. That's difficult. That ball got up and swirled a little bit in the wind. Made it difficult for him, but it was a little bit of a strange tactic. I think he's just trying to keep Michael Chang honest. Just all of a sudden running into net sort of at a mistimed situation.
Because folks at home will look at him and say, gee, I might try that, you know. And it is not a good idea. It does change reaction.
It's like a golfer out there looking for the ball to land on the green.
Something's like the sound system getting to stay in there. Or the annoying buzz, if you hear it.
Feel like feedback on the speakers. Set break point, and there's a distraction. And instead, he comes up with an ace. Didn't bother him too much.
There'll be a delay. I wonder if he'll give him two now in the middle of the point. I bet he will. Let's see. No? Didn't ask for two either. Second serve. First serve, well done. By the way, I mean, the guys at home are saying, God,
that's... He was going to throw the ball up waiting for the buzz to go off, but it didn't go off.
What happens if after he uses first serve, he misses it, and then it goes off again?
That's my point.
Be a first. Humor exchange between Michael Chang and an opponent. That's terrific.
Second serve at deuce. First game, third set.
Said, well, suppose now he serves and it gets all the way over to my side of the court and then the buzzer goes on. And the answer was, well, then it's my point, Jay Berger. So it's very simple, it's mine.
Break point for Chang.
Knew it for softening it up a little bit more, and then it makes that hard ball when he hits it even more effective.
Deuce.
Makes a shot, but Michael Chang is too quick also. Here you can see Michael Chang. And see the form he uses? I mean, in other words, he hits that ball, and he is ready. hits, gets back in position, that's how he gets to the next ball. Great balance.
Deuce. First game of the match was the same kind of game.
See, when he gets a little bit of a bad luck and that the let court pops the ball right up. Now watch his concentration. He's looking straight at the ball, keeping his eye on it, gets right down. That's how he's able to make that volley.
Firm wrist, too.
Yep, you really just got to zero right in, though, to keep the racket there. And just not give up on it.
A situation like that, though, you've got to guess one way or the other. So there's no way you can cover all the options. Did and he guessed right. This is Deuce, second serve.
I think he was surprised that he got the return back then, and he really didn't have a game plan in mind and went in on an approach shot that really was ill-advised. See, definitely was ill-advised when you have to try to hit a shot off the ground like that.
Break point again. Berger's serving into the sun. Berger's had 8 chances to break. He's broken 3 times.
About Jay Berger did it perfectly just then. He stopped, took his time, did a little housekeeping around the baseline, regaining his concentration because deuce points are huge. So he took his time before he started the point, got an idea in mind what he wanted to do and did it.
So we're game points and this is one, first game, third set.
Berger's getting in position. The ball lands just a little bit short, though. If you see where that ball bounced, it bounced just on the other side of the service line. That's too short when you're playing Michael Chang.
Still took a pretty good shot. I mean, it's a good shot to win the point, didn't it? Deuce.
It's a great shot. Just seems like he makes them all the time.
He's not going to let him play too. I mean, the fans go off indoors all the time. Jackson. I don't think there's anything in the rules which says that if a friend goes over the stadium, you get to be a two. Anyway, after all said and done, here's another break point, first game, third set for Chang. Chang 1-0 with a break in the third set.
Well, Cliff, as we've seen the last couple of days, Michael Chang is nothing if not composed in the third set. And that's laudatory. But there's a part of me that's a little bit sad to see Michael Chang because he is so composed. He is almost startlingly and uncannily composed for one who's only 18 years old. I wonder, does he have fun? Here is a guy who has the world of tennis riding on his shoulders at 18. And sometimes when I talk to him and his family, I get the feeling, gee, the guy's on death row. I wish I could just say, let's go play frisbee one of these days, guys, and get away from professional tennis. I remember I was with 18-year-olds in Vietnam, which took life, I think, sometimes more likely than professional tennis players do. And this is not an indictment of Michael Chang. I don't want him to change his personality or anything. He's a great kid. It's just that sometimes I just wish, I wonder, do they have the fun that the rest of 18-year-olds in the world have? I just don't know. I hope he does.
There's something that the tour has changed since the days that, decades ago when it was amateur tennis, and the players really were a family because they traveled together for 10, 11, even up to 12 months a year. Now, of course, that has all changed. It's one of the differences. Someone in the crowd is delaying things. And this is Chang serving.
If you see them in the elevator, like this morning with Jay Berger, I mean, the guy's a young fellow. Michael Chang, he looks 18 when you're up next to him. It's tough to realize that when you see him on the court. Of all the athletes I've ever seen in sport, Michael Chang has a composure that's really quite extraordinary.
No! 15:30, Berger trying to get back on serve in the second set. He's down a break, one game to love.
balls that are looping. He's actually having some miss hits that have been quite effective. Then when he does rifle that ball for the approach shot, it's causing Michael Chang to miss him because he's not used to the speed of that shot, as opposed to every ball being hit hard like an Agassi does.
Still break point here for Jay Berger.
A little bit of a short return there, set that up.
Would rather play somebody who's slow and fat and overweight, but you know, it'd be more fun to play somebody who can't run at all, but that's the guy I play. I don't expect to get to the finals of a tournament and have a duck match, you know. It just doesn't happen too often.
One game more. This is Jay Berger 7.
Like a duck. It is a duck. Michael Chang is no duck. $55,000 at stake in this set. So that he's not going to have to play one of the top eight seeds to get to the finals of the Open.
Yeah, to do it in time, he's got to be here and probably in the next 2 weeks.
Yeah,
that's all. It's the only time left. I would hate to be a seeded player and have to play him in the first round.
Exactly. Seeded, but of course, if you get seeded below eight, you've got to play one of the top eight seeds to get the quarters. And so where you're seeded as well makes a difference. Game point for Berger to go up 2-1. Sun's behind him now.
It would be awfully difficult for him to get ranked in the top eight by the time the US Open.
It would be. Hot down there, as you can tell. Especially right on the court.
Interesting, Cliff and Roscoe, to take a look at these two players and how they're walking at this stage of the match. But Berger seems to be the fresher of the two players. I don't know if Michael is trying to conserve energy, but Jay has still got plenty of spunk in his step. Chang moving considerably more slowly.
This is getting to be old hat to Chang. He's doing this every day now.
Yeah. I say moving slowly between points.
Game point for Berger.
spin volley, which really he hadn't decided he was going to go in, and it just gave Michael Chang a little too much time. And each time that Jay Berger has sort of made his mind up to go into the net, but he's made it up late, then he's paid for it. The decision to go in needs to be made earlier. And such where the chances are really not called for. That last shot to try to hit that ball down the line, there's the percentage of having anything good happen out of that are very, very low. Because it's not really in a position. He's well behind the baseline. He's not really in a position to hit a winner.
He's in trouble now. Same thing happened against Sampras. Had a bit of a valley at the beginning of the third set, then things picked up. Out! Well, to say that there is a pace to any athletic event. If you take a look at Michael Chang taking some glucose tablets during the break. Those are not salt tablets, that's glucose.
Dirty love chain.
We have come some way since there was the salt tablet craze. I know 20 years ago they used to, even in preseason football, they used to give us salt tablets. That, as a matter of fact, is now contraindicated. You don't do that. It makes things worse.
You used to eat steak and eggs 2 hours before you played, too. That was always a thing to do.
Yeah, I can hear your arteries hardening from here, Cliff.
Things should do change. Of course, you never know. Next year, we might get back to steak and eggs. Don't you think?
I don't think so.
I don't either.
That range-fed beef, low cholesterol beef.
30-15, Chang, 2-1. Third set.
30-15.
Thank you. I may have mentioned earlier in the program, I think he underestimated the effect of the hip injury, and he kind of conned us a little bit early in the year, said he was okay. He clearly was not okay, but I think he has put many of those worries to bed this week.
Difficult on Jay Berger because now he's going to be crazy just to hold serve to get within one game. And so the edge shifts dramatically to Michael Chang now, not just that it's 3-1, but it's hot. It's third set, they're tired.
Earlier this year, for example, losing the first round to Leyendeck, and then he went to the Japan Open, and Aaron Krikstein beat him. And he said after that, no, actually, Krikstein just played better than he did. But later he said, well, maybe I should. It's not easy when you're 18 years old. You've been offered jillions of dollars to play all over the world.
Necessarily blame him for that. I mean, it's part of the management profile that he has. I mean, they don't want to turn down that kind of money. They're taking anywhere from 10 to 25% of his prize money. So you look at his brother, Carl.
Position just like Jay Berger was just then, and you're playing against a fast player, the tendency is to try to overplay your shot and try to make it too perfect, and also to take a little peek. And on that shot, he did take a little bit of a peek to see if Michael Chang was going to be able to run it down.
Tough position for Jay Berger. He's got to hold on here. He's serving into the sun. 15, I should say 30, 15.
See his serve, and now he gets ready, and he's getting ready. He has good deception on that drop shot. And I think what he's trying to do is bring Michael Chang forward. Almost gets to that ball. He gets to it, but it almost gets it in. But he's trying to bring Michael Chang forward, so he's not playing quite so deep in the court. But he doesn't have the luxury of trying to set things up at this particular point. He's down 3-1 in the third. See, watch how quickly Michael Chang prepares. Now he's hit that ball, he's moving back to the center, the racket's back. Before you see the ball enter the picture, the racket is back. That's how he's able to hit these passing shots, and he stays right with his shot all the way through it. Thank you. past this point, Jay Berger absolutely drilled some of these balls. Chang will go after everything. Say that maybe he wanted to conserve his energy in the third.
That was a great point for the second break. So, you know, he's not, I mean, that could have canceled out the match, really. Two breaks, that should do it. This is deuce.
Michael Chang's first appearance here at this Canadian Open. Jay Berger got to the semis here last year, lost to John McEnroe, who won here back in 1984 and 85. That's a patented topspin forehand. Usually that's a very, very diabolical cross court. Doesn't quite make it this time. Catches the top of the net. Lendl has won here as well. Lendl's won here six times. Been in the finals eight times. And Lendl would have liked to be here this time. And he has a still cliff, as everybody, most of you know by now, has a continuing thigh bruise that I guess has been bothering him some.
He was entered in the tournament but had to pull out from this and the Mercedes last week in Germany to play. But he has he's been here for the last decade. Crucial stages of this match. Jay Berger, who has said his game break three games to one. Break points in this game on his serve. It's deuce. Changes with this resurgence of Michael Chang, semi-finalist last week, now a finalist here, and a probable winner at this point with a break in the third set. We've got the obvious choices, Lendl, Edward Beckham, and Agassi. Jim Courier, Pete Sampras played so well here, and Michael Chang for sure has potential winners. Chang first. Comeback. Jay Berger, all kinds of trouble.
time.
Chang's up a break, 3-2. He was so close to being up two breaks, would have been 4-1. Wasn't able to convert. Jay Berger is still very much alive in this match. Chang serving into the sun. Watch.
It's interesting because with his forehand, he's really controlling the point with his backhand. He didn't want to drop shot it again. That's the one he's been drop shotting. Maybe he says to himself, well, at least the drop shot goes in the court.
It's tough when you play against Chang because you know how quick he is. 5-2 minutes. Oh! Errors.
Thank you.
shot. It's a little bit short, but it was hit very hard. And watch how he just stays with it. You know, it's just like this is just a casual shot against those ball machines. Nice kick. It's unbelievable. This is three on the third. He didn't even get a little edgy about it. He said, okay, I'll pass you.
15. So there's a lot at stake here in the Canadian national title.
You see the forehand as he's moving forward into the net.
15 all, three games all, one set all. Dead solid even.
As much as these guys put into every shot they hit, they're in tremendous physical condition.
And this heat. Hard court. Right.
Oh! 15-30.
Every time they give up an easy point like that, or a lackadaisical point, a double fault, unforced errors, they start to really mound up. And from three all onwards, they're going to count way heavy on anyone's game.
Stretches almost all the way along. Doesn't happen often, but every so often the ball will hit in that spot and just slide right under your racket. I've tried to correct it over the years, but there's not a heck of a lot you can do about it, apparently. Seven aces for Berger.
Shot to the forehand side. And goes, all right, this is mine. Thank you. And he slips. He's coming back and putting in for this next ball already. And watch this racket go back. Ball's not even there yet, and the racket is back. That's how it makes it look so simple.
Break point for Chang.
Time.
before the ball bounces, that's how he's able to get the money back and make a positive shot out of that. And could have won the match point right there.
Brother Carl watches.
And he serves an ace to open the game. That's a great way to start consolidating your service point.
As well as he does. Keep your eye on him because he goes one way and the ball goes the other.
And he just gets in such good position. Look at Chang, he's there. He can take his pick, and that makes it's really just Berger's just hung out to dry when he's standing right there.
30 love.
Fuse in the back end, he just mishits it, hooks it wide. In a row. This is his third in 3 days. But there is no fatigue evident in either player's debut. Four games. Oh!
Sampras came back to tie it up and go on and win that set, and here Jay Berger was down 1-3, and he has struggled back and drawn even. Looking at a bit of a mirror image of himself as Michael Chang today. In some ways, going to hang on every bit and every much as every bit as
Are you making a prediction, Kim?
I'm still picking Chang, but I think this is a. This game is
shot. Huge shot. And now he gets in. Now watch him punch that volley. That had more juice on it than the others. His backhand side, he plays and doesn't get the same punch that he gets out of the forehand volley.
Jay Berger beat Hlasek yesterday. Excuse me. Go ahead, Ken.
No, I'm just going to quickly say that I'll get to it after this point. But.
Sets over Hlasek in the semifinal. Chang's going to have to serve into the sun to keep things alive in the next game if Berger holds on.
Jay Berger had decided before he hit that serve that he was going to net, because you saw that when he finished the motion, he was already on his way. Capitalize on the high floating return. And he did it.
So Jay Berger is ahead, 5-4, and we'll come back. Michael Chang will serve to try to stay in the Canadian National Championship.
This is the Canadian Open final. Michael Chang serving 5-4 against him. Jay Berger has the lead. We're on serve, one set all.
Opportunity to come into net and take control of the point. See that concentration looking at the ball? It's fantastic. One thing, though, Jay Berger might want to do is mix up a couple of shots, float a couple of balls, just see what happens, like that. That was his idea, was to soften it up and try to keep it hard.
Five apiece in the third set.
plays the game, and the sense of the match that Edmund played, the ability to summon, not an inspired shot, but I think now as this match approaches 3 hours, you're gonna look at Jay Berger. If his brain isn't a bit out by the heat, I'm surprised.
Seldom that you cover a match in which you can so often say exactly the same thing about both players.
Yeah. What do you say we call it? Declare it a tie. Get out of the sun.
15-0.
Doesn't have the sun in his face on that side. Unless the wind is swirling, it appears that maybe he has a little bit of a breeze in his back, but I guess maybe there's no breeze down there at all.
The longest match in Canadian Open history in the final, and no signs of fatigue from either guy, actually, at this point. Longest match since 1986.
A little bit. I'm down here at courtside. Some of the dignitaries for the closing ceremonies have come down here. I think they were a bit premature. They've moved out of the sun now.
Now they're going to get warm.
Berger beat Leif Shiras here in the first round that he played, then Derek Rospagno in three sets, Tim Mayotte after a tiebreak in the first set, and then Jacob Plasek in three sets. Serving at 5-6, third set. Oh! This is the last set of this year's Canadian singles championship.
The dance contest was the most grueling thing you could do. I don't know. I wonder if those folks have ever seen Jay Berger and Michael Chang play in 100 degree heat. Dog day afternoon.
This has been the Michael Chang Show. wonder if he can finish up with a Cinderella story, or whether Jay Berger, as well as he has played, can spoil it for him. 15 all.
Shorties, big trouble, but this might be an opportunity. He's played three hard points now. Might be an opportunity to just give a couple of soft shots. Shot, it throws Michael Chang off of his timing on the hard ball so that when he comes back with a rocket in the next shot, Michael Chang's not quite as ready for it. That's what he's been doing all through the match. To mix it.
Passing shot, but he just didn't hit the shot.
Otherwise, Michael Chang hit that approach shot, and he came in, but that was really more of a bluff coming in, and he really didn't have the shot. He didn't hit the shot, anyway, that he needed to hit to come in, but it sort of shocked Jay Berger, and Jay Berger was surprised that he had that opportunity. These guys are fooling each other.
Game point. Break records for these two players, and 1990 Berger is, as you can see, percentage wise in a lot better shape than Chang. But, that has been up to this point.
Chang won a big one yesterday.
Oh, yeah. Second consensus.
It's interesting the demeanor of the two players as they walk around. Jay Berger's got a running conversation going. Michael Chang is perfectly quiet.
Like this, and he is staying right on the ball. He's not giving up, not giving an inch.
You see, he's down to the ball, keeping his eye on it. There. Determination.
I I think you're going to see Berger coming in that a little more now. I think he has lost just a skosh of confidence in his ground strokes. Lost the first 2 points in the tiebreaker on ground stroke errors. I think he'd like to get to net.
To one chain.
Jay Berger on this point, he's really going for it. He steps up and he drills this backhand return. He's going to take advantage now, but watch how he gets some pace. He gets much more solid on his backhand. A little while there in the early parts of the third set, he was babying his backhand. Very courageous when he stepped up ahead.
Jay Berger with the sun now behind him, so the sun's not going to present any problem for him. And you can see Michael Chang throwing the ball up there just to check where the sun is. It's not in a good spot for him. Chang is 2 points from the match.
Big Sampras.